Got myself a espresso machine for Christmas. What's happening, guys? Welcome back to another video. I hope you all had a really good break over Christmas and New Year period. I've had about 3 weeks off. I've got a few projects on the go, so I need to get all these gear reviews out of the way so I can get onto this major project which I have going on. I'll be talking about it in another video, but just so you guys know what's coming up, I did buy myself a KTM adventure bike. It's a 500 EXE and I'm super excited about it. I'm going to ride from the top of the North Island to all the way down the bottom of the South Island, taking photos, meeting with people, reviewing lenses, going into camera shops around the country, and just having a great time doing a photography adventure trip, camping out off the back of a motorbike. So really looking forward to that. Watch out for that series coming up soon. In today's video though, we are going to review the new Sigma 35mm f2. It's the tiny little lens that I guess is kind of meant to rival the Sony 35mm 1.8 FE lens that came out a little while ago. The Sigma does some things a little bit better, the Sony does some things a little bit better. So let's get onto it. I am going to do a separate video just comparing the two side by side so you guys can see the images without me talking about it and looking at my face all the time. So watch out for that video as well. I'll have raw files in there, and I'll also have raw files to download from the photos you'll see today so you can play with them yourself. Now all of these photos were just edited with my presets. All the photos of my boys skateboarding were with the Portra 400 preset, which I made to match when I was shooting film a lot. And the photos of my motorbike were all edited with CTM3 in pack 2, which is also on my store if you want to check those out and support the channel. And all the video footage was just shot in S-Log 2 with ProColor in 4K, 25p, 100 megabit a second, and just graded with my LUT. So I've had the lens for a couple of days. I've been mucking around with it at home. I took my boys out skateboarding and we got a few photos of that. I went out this morning and went for a ride on my motorbike and got a few photos of that in the city. So first, talking about build quality, and I'm going to be comparing it a little bit to the 35mm 1.8. The Sony lens is a little bit more expensive, but they're around the same ballpark, the Sigma just being a little bit cheaper. So build quality, the Sigma is definitely miles better than the Sony lens. Not that the Sony lens is bad, but the Sigma lens for the money is really, really well built. It's all metal, it feels really nice. The focus ring and aperture ring are really nice to use, and it has a weather sealing gasket on the back of it, which the Sony doesn't have. Although Sony do say it's dust and weather resistant, it just feels like the Sigma is a little bit more weather sealed. I do really enjoy having the aperture ring on the lens, which the Sony one doesn't have. I guess I'm just used to it with all my G-Master lenses, and I do use it to change aperture. Although you don't need to use it, you can just switch it all the way down to the A mode, and then you can use the front or rear dial, however you have it programmed to change the aperture. The Sigma does have the AF-MF switch on the side, which is really handy. I hate having to go into the menu to change to manual focus if I want to do that. And the only thing it's missing is a function button on the side of the lens, which I never really use on my lenses. I guess I just forget it's there. It's not part of my workflow, but if some of you guys want that, you're going to be missing it on the Sigma lens. Again, versus the Sony 35 1.8, the Sigma is a little bit heavier at about 325 grams. The Sony is about 285 grams, I think. So both really, really light and really, really small. The Sigma is just a little bit bigger and a little bit heavier. But yeah, again, a still really compact option for traveling around. I could fit it in my, I have a tiny little tank bag on my motorbike and it fits in there no problem with my A7R4. Now talking about focus, the Sigma performs really, really fantastic. It doesn't have any of the issues that I suffered with my 35mm 1.2 Sigma lens, which has all been fixed now thanks to Sigma. I had a really good talk with the guys there, the suppliers. And they have probably talked to a bunch of other people that had the issue, and it's all been fixed now with the firmware. I can definitely confirm that no issues at all with the 35mm 1.2. Saying that, no issues also with the 35mm f2, the one I've been trying out now. Works really well. It also focuses really well for video. And one thing I notice with the Sigma lens is the manual focus is really, really nice on this one. It's really easy to manually focus. It doesn't suffer from that speed issue, I guess. I'm not exactly sure what it's called, but like on my 24mm G-Master, for example, or any most of the Sony lenses, they're all fly-by-wire, but if you focus at different speeds, you get different distances. And the Sigma one is just really linear and really easy to manual focus for video or photo. In terms of autofocus, the photo focus works really fantastic. Tracking works flawlessly. Real-time tracking works great, which was the issue I had with some of the other lenses. And video focus works fantastic. It tracks really great with subjects coming towards you. I took a few clips of my boys here coming towards me and then going off on their skateboards, and it tracked them no issues at all, so I'm really happy with that. It's also really quiet to focus. It doesn't have any noise. All these clips at the start of the video, to be fair, I have music over it and stuff, but you can't hear any sound, and I was just using the internal camera mic. In terms of optical quality now, it's definitely a great lens. It does suffer a tiny bit of chromatic aberration. Nothing too serious, really easy to fix, just a bit of purple fringing. And in terms of sharpness, it's great. At wide open, at f2, it's really nice and sharp, and it does get a lot sharper at like 2.8 to f4. Really tack sharp there. I think the Sigma 35mm 1.8 is a little bit sharper when it's wide open, but you're going to have to look at my comparison video to check those sample images out. I always recommend just downloading them for yourself, so you can just look at them 100% on your computer rather than watching a YouTube video. It makes it a little bit easier. The colors are really nice. It's not quite as warm as the other Sigma lenses, which is kind of nice, to be honest. I find the Sony G-Master lenses are quite cool, or maybe not cool, just accurate, where the Sigma lenses, like my 1.4-85, is quite a lot warmer, so you can't really sync white balance and post when I'm shooting with my 24 and my 85. But the 35mm Sigma is about in between them. It's not too warm, it's not too cool, it just has a really nice tone to it. It does have quite a bit of distortion. I'm not sure if there's a profile yet because I haven't updated my Lightroom. I'm sure there is, but you can easily fix it with about plus 10 distortion in Lightroom on the manual correction, as I've done in these photos you're seeing. But definitely worth noting, it does have quite a bit of pincushion distortion. Vignetting is definitely apparent when it's wide open. It's nothing too serious. It definitely doesn't vignette as much as the 35mm 1.2 did. But again, easy to fix. It's a really awesome lightweight compact lens. So if it's something you're looking at, a 35mm, definitely recommend it. If it was me, I probably would buy it over the 35mm 1.8, but there's really not too much in it. I would just save a couple of $100s, depending on where you are in the world. I've looked around at prices, and some places it's about the same. Some places the Sigma's a little bit cheaper, so really depends, but definitely recommend checking out my video on my head-to-head comparison with the 35mm 1.8. If you guys want to see any other lenses in that video, let me know as well. So that's pretty much it, guys. Thanks for watching. Really great to see you all again. I really appreciate all the comments coming in, subscribers, everything. I couldn't do this without you guys, so thanks a lot. Give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video in a few days.